Good evening, friends. This is Bhargav. I wanted to explain a hacker rank challenge one problem to each and every person, such that each and every person will be benefited by my lectures. So the first lecture is finding a string. Okay, so the user gives you a string and a substring. What is string and what is substring? So string is nothing but a sequence of characters obtained. So this is a sequence of characters, one by one character. These all characters are named as strings. So the part of a string is called as a substring. So you have to tell how many times the substring is occurred in a particular string. Okay, so that is substring. So CDC is right. So CDC, CDC, it occurred two times. So let's complete this challenge. I wanted to explain you theoretically in the book so that you can write the code for that simply, and I'll explain you the code even, so that would be more beneficial for each and every person. So the given input is A, B, C, D, C, D, C. So this is an input, right? So you have to see the how many times the CDC occurred in a particular string. Okay, so let me take you. So you have to check CDC where it has occurred in the an input string. So CDC occurred one time and two times. You have to see the this kind of things. So let me explain you the problem thorough way. Okay, so CDC is right. So I wanted to take this in the form of an array. As per my idea, I'll take this in the form of an array. Okay, so I'll write the index numbers for this 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is my array. Okay, I wanted to see the CDC whether it is present in this array or not. Okay, how can you check? You can't check by character. Okay, how can you check character by C? This is the whole string and the part of substring. So ABC. So I wanted to check this index, and after that this index, and after that this index, and after the this index, and after the this index, where the string breaks. So I wanted to check sequence of characters, character by character. Okay, so I wanted to take this character first, 0 to 2. So A of 0 is to 2. So what is 0 is to 2? ABC. ABC equal to CDC. Is it correct? No. Right. So I wanted to check BCD. So BCD is equal to CDC. Is it correct? No. And CDC equal to CDC. Is it correct? Yes, it is correct. So count equal to 1. Okay, so count is equal to 1. At one time it has occurred, right? The count equal to 1. And another probability, again this character, I wanted to increase this character. So DCD, so DCD equal to CDC. CDC, is it correct? No, it is wrong. So count has breaked, right? So next, again I wanted to increment CDC. CD is equal to CDC. Is it correct? Yes. So the count equal to 1. So count equal to 2, right? So let me come into the solution. So my idea is, I want to scan the whole string. I wanted to take this string. So I consider this as A and the substring as B. Okay. So I wanted to subtract this string from this string and add it. And I want to check whether the string is equal to this B or not. Okay, so they may be given any string. So Bhargav, so this is my name, Gav. So Gav, you wanted to check this one, Gav. So here you wanted to see how many times the string is equal to the Gav, and how many times Gav, Gav, Gav. So the count is equal to 3, right? So like that, this is my idea. I want to scan the whole string. I'll take an input and I'll take an input. Any substring. Okay, so A equal to, so I wanted to take raw input dot strip. So this is my string actually, right? So this is my string. This string I'm taking in the form of strip. Strip means what? It splits the string. It splits. So the splitting of the string has happened in A. The substring I wanted to take, the same thing, dot strip. Okay, So this two steps, though, for taking the input and the substring, I have written these two lines. Okay, these two lines. So I wanted to take the loop. For this, I wanted to take the loop. So I have to travel each and every line, right? So not each and every line, each and every index I have to travel, right? So for that, I wanted to take the loop. For I in range, so I wanted to take the length of this string and then length of this string, length of A minus length of B plus 1. Okay, I hope you understand this. So what is this length of the string? 6, and length of B string minus 3 plus 1. 6 minus 3, 3 plus 1, 4. So up to here it will travel, and again it will travel from here to here. Okay, so I hope you can understand this one. So next, if I is 2, so I wanted to take the index number, right? If I is 2, wait guys, 1 minute. Okay, so I, and I wanted to take as a loop, right? So I is 2, length of B string plus 1. Okay, I am length of B string plus 1 is equals to B. Okay, so I'll explain you this logic. Bolo, I told you, right? From 0 to 2, it has to travel. I wanted to consider this string length, and I wanted to check. So this string is part of this string, right? So this substring is a part of this string. So I wanted to take individual string ABC equal to CDC, CDC equal to CDC, and DCD is equal to CDC, CD is equal to CDC. So I is to length plus 1 is equal to B. So B is my substring. Whether it is equal or I'm checking, right? So whether it is equal or equal, equal or equal. So then what will happen is count will increase. Count plus equal to 1. So until it is equal, the count becomes equal. Okay. So it increases, the count was increases. So count plus equal to 1. So I hope you understand this logic. So A is raw input dot string. So it will split the string. Even B the same the string. So substring means there's a part of a string. Okay. A part of an individual part of a string is substring. Okay. So it will check individual parts and it will give the count value. So here, let's see the count value, how the code works. So input strip and strip. So for I in range, length of A, what is length of A? 0 is to 6, 5. The string length is 6 and minus 3 plus 1. So 6 minus 3, 3 plus 1, 4. Up to here it will travel, and again it will increase the count and checks the value of substring. Then it will increase the count. Okay, so I hope you can understand this logic. So I this is my way of thinking. So let's see how you will think and how you'll produce a solution. I hope you can share this video to the people.